Welcome to The Jump. Look, I'm alongside my day one's New York Times bestseller, Brian Windhorst, from his home in Nebraska, and the Hall of Famer is back with us, Tracy McGrady, from his home in Houston. You guys just saw a clip from our very first show back in 2016. Thought it would be fun to flash back with you guys today because things have changed, guys.
Just a little bit.
It's different in these boxes. Coming up, Commissioner Silver said on Friday that, quote, everything is on the table when it comes to finishing this NBA season. We will discuss just how feasible any idea is at this point. First, though, we're going to begin with the NBA's answer to Tiger King. ESPN Films' The Last Dance debuted last night. And for two wonderful hours, the sports world got to forget about all the shutdowns and look back at one of the all-time greatest teams. Tracy, I know how excited you were for this film. So what was your favorite moment? What stuck out to you from the first two episodes last night?
Well, me being not up on, there was two episodes last night. After the first episode, I turned it off, not thinking it was another one came on. So I woke up this morning, got online, and seeing everybody talking about these two episodes. I'm like, what the hell? So I had to go online and watch the second episode this morning. But the first thing that really stuck out to me, because I almost was a part of that, is 1997, Jerry Krause wanted to trade Scottie Pippen. And he was, you know, it was said if they went 82-0, no matter what, he was going to dismantle that team. And to me, it's like they just won two championships going for that third, and then you win a third championship and you still want to dismantle the team. Like, I thought it was all about winning and winning chips. And to Jerry Krause, like, I know he's not here with us and he can't defend himself. And for me, you know, I had like a personal connection because he tried to trade Scottie Pippen for me on draft night. So that really
stuck out. That was crazy. You revealed that on one of our early shows and it blew my mind.
Listen,
it was that they tried to trade you.
The last hours of draft before draft night, I flew to Chicago and got a physical and had conversations with Jerry Krause and everything. And he was real serious about trying to get me in that draft.
And no. Michael Jordan, you said, is the one who put the kibosh on that. Although, considering what kind of player you turned into, I don't know what the future would have looked like with the two of you. Brian, what did you think seeing all the stuff about Jerry Krause?
You know, Michael is obviously the GOAT of a lot of things, including holding grudges. And he's got his hand on this documentary, and he has been angry at Jerry Krause for 25 or 30 years, and he is letting him have it full bore in this documentary so far, and I think we're going to see more of it. And I was aware of it at the time. A lot of this stuff wasn't a secret. It's amazing to have it brought back. You know, Jerry Krause, I guess you could build a laboratory and say that if he was worried that the best of Scottie Pippen was going by, that the way to extend the window of that player rather than lose him for nothing, which they essentially did. They traded him for like a second-round pick in Roy Rogers. I guess you could say that in the laboratory, but we don't live in a laboratory. And if you look at the dynasties that have followed, they have played till the very end. If you look at, you know, the Warriors, they broke up after a loss in the finals. The Heat, a loss in the finals. The Cavs, a loss in the finals. Everybody runs till the wheels fall off because they all remember the mistake of Jerry Krause in not letting this team play until they took a loss.
And the wheels were not falling off Scottie Pippen in any way. If you take a look at the numbers, there's no question Scottie is not Michael Jordan. Only Michael Jordan is Michael Jordan. But Michael Jordan wasn't Michael Jordan without Scottie Pippen. I don't see, when you look at the numbers and you look at how everything is, how you don't see the value that he had. And he's one of the 50 greatest players ever. The idea, as noted by the NBA, just the idea that people wouldn't realize what they had in that locker room is beyond me. And I think what I like about this documentary is that I think some of the younger generation who just knows Scottie as that guy who played with Michael Jordan is going to be able to understand just how good he was. Brian, what was your favorite moment from the documentary?
Well, I mean, maybe Michael has said this before and I never heard it, but my head moved back a little bit when he talked about he went from being Mike Jordan to Michael Jordan after hitting that shot to win the national title at North Carolina. And I've often wondered, where did his leadership and his drive to win blossom? Where did it come from? Because I know rookies. I see how they are when they come in the league. Even the most confident rookies have so much to learn. And him describing that in one sentence illustrates how he was able to come into the NBA with so much confidence. And even though we're in an era where we're still trying to get high school guys directly into the NBA, it's a reminder of how important those developmental years are.
Mm-hmm. Well, as someone who grew up in the D.C. area, Brian, and loved Georgetown basketball, I really appreciate you bringing that up again today. Reliving it last night wasn't bad enough, so thank you.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.